Yes, ladies and gentlemen, you are reading this right. The Wolf Among Us 2 new details, new screenshots have been dropped. Not really, courtesy of our good friend Dom the Bomb. You already know him, legend in covering Telltale Games, Life is Strange, Last of Us 2. Huge shout out to him. Yesterday, or actually a day or two before, Telltale Games posted an end of the year update where they said, you know, look out for a Game Informer magazine in early 2022. And I was like, you know what, cool, we'll wait for early 2022 and then we will check it out and then cover it. I go to sleep, I wake up, and bam, on my timeline I see a bunch of these screenshots coming out of nowhere, and I'm like, what just happened, ladies and gentlemen? So apparently Game Informer's magazine, the monthly issue, shared a ton of details regarding The Wolf Among Us 2. So you know what, ladies and gentlemen, without wasting any more time, boys, let us jump straight into it. First look at Bigby Wolf, the man himself, and Snow White in the upcoming The Wolf Among Us 2 via Game Informer, shared by Dom the Bomb. As you can see on your screen, ladies and gentlemen, this is actually our first look at both of these characters. Yes, we have seen Bigby before in a trailer released by Telltale Games a while back, but scratch that, because that does not represent the current production, which we'll talk about in just a second. But look at him! He looks disgusting. The art has been refined, so it looks even better, sharper. Disgusting. I mean, disgustingly good, ladies and gentlemen. And Snow White too, like, this art for this new game, The Wolf Among Us 2, it's literally perfect. And a part of me kind of wanted, kind of wished, kind of hoped to see Wolf Among Us 2 during this time, like during winter. It would have been such a perfect title for this kind of season. Now watch this game dropping next year's December. I hope not. Hey, if that happens, don't come back here, alright? That was just my wishful thinking for 2021, not 2022. But anyways, ladies and gentlemen, I will be playing the screenshots on your screens. Another thing to look at, ladies and gentlemen, is Fabletown Apartment. So in the Game Informer, we also got our first look / concept art for the apartment in the upcoming Wolf Among Us 2, and this is a typical Telltale. This is literally like all the Telltale fans know. We live and breathe this kind of art style, this kind of stuff from Telltale Games, and I'm so glad they're keeping it. You know, whilst The Expanse looked great, looked phenomenal and all that, I still like their style, and I really hope that they keep it, because that is something that kind of, you know, gives them an edge. I know they can do much higher quality, like realistic graphics, but you know, a part of me, like, we're here for the story, and this art style defines Telltale Games and all that, so you know, it is what it is, ladies and gentlemen. That's just my personal opinion. Hey, if they want to go for a realistic route, by all means. I know for a fact that Deck 9 Games will handle facial animations in the Expanse Telltale series perfectly. Look at True Colors, which makes me even more excited for Life is Strange Remaster, which, by the way, we will play it here on the channel. So now that we've talked about all of this, let's take a look at some of the details surrounding this upcoming game. So number one, and I'm so happy, I thought this is dead, but Telltale Games are revived, because they're back, they've been revived, they revived one of the older projects, they're also bringing something else back, ladies and gentlemen. So as we know, Life is Strange True Colors, the whole game dropped at once. No episodic or chapter system, it had one, but it dropped all together, like you can play it from the beginning till the end. Well, the good news here is, and I'm quoting Dom by the way, that the game will indeed release in 5 episodes. There will be a separate episodic release. However, we will only have to wait only a couple weeks in between. Telltale will announce the release schedule ahead of time, just like they did for The Walking Dead Season 4, I think, announcing all the episodes' release date ahead of time, so that will give everyone a head start, like, hey, okay, episodes release on these dates. Not a big wait, and I'm really happy that they brought this back, because this is like literally the life of for Telltale Games. Releasing one episode, looking at the reaction, theorizing the upcoming episodes, waiting forward to, bro, it is so much fun. If you were here for the Walking Dead days, you know how insane those were, and I really hope this right here brings it back. And by the way, in the end of the year update, they said that they still have rights to the Batman, which, I know, I keep repeating here over and over again that Batman Season 3 will happen at some point, and Batman Shadows Edition was literally a test run for that. They released a Shadow Edition to see if there's still hype, there's still interest, and guess what? Universally, people agree, non-Telltale fans and Telltale fans, that Batman Season 2 in specific, Season 1 too, was one of Telltale's best work and one of the best Batman's stories that were told, and I loved it. So I'm really hoping season 3, because I'm a huge Batman fan. But anyways, we're getting off topic. New York City will play a big role. It is set in winter, ladies and gentlemen. It is 6 months after the events of the first game. 6 months. So yes, this is continuing in timeline. And there's some additional information here that, quote, game will take place after Snow White steps in as deputy mayor of Fabletown. That is very interesting. We'll see her in action big time. Bigby struggles with his transition from typical fairy tale villain to sheriff and protector that should be. That's going to be the heart of the story. This game will explore the difficulties of hiding in plain sight, dealing with new fables all over New York. And we're not just done here, ladies and gentlemen. If you were curious as to how they're gonna handle the animation, since, you know, it is the new Telltale, it is the new revived Telltale, but don't worry, ladies and gentlemen, it is confirmed that Wolf Among Us 2 will be the first Telltale title that will be using motion capture technology. And as you can see on your screen right now, ladies and gentlemen, and yes, if you didn't know already, they have transitioned from their engine to Unreal Engine. So they are using Unreal Engine, which you might think that it's gonna make a little bit difficult for the company. No, they're actually happy because it has streamlined a lot of struggles and problems for the development, and it is helping them. So that is a great thing, number one. And number two, they're using mocap for the animations, so you already know the Wolf Among Us will be the most advanced Telltale title, and I'm happy. I'm so excited. So ladies and gentlemen, all of the details we know so far, there are other details that we'll learn in early 2022, so make sure to stay tuned for that. Like I told you before, this channel wouldn't be here without Telltale, so I owe this to my past self and my present and future self as well. We will be covering all things Telltale on this channel. Shout out to Tom the Bomb for all of this. Shout out to Telltale. Shout out to Ad Hoc Studios. The Wolf Among Us 2, ladies and gentlemen, It's gonna be that chisel. You know, one day. One can only hope one day. Walking Dead game season 5. I'll stop. Okay, this is where I'm gonna do this video. Please subscribe, follow me Twitter and Instagram, and that is Magnify. And I'll see you in the next video. Until then, take care and peace.